Hello there guys, welcome back to the channel, I'm Fox2. And in today's video, I'm going to be talking about War Thunder Mobile's naval battles, and what I think of it, particularly in comparison to many other naval battle games. Now this is not actually going to be a comparison, but there will be some aspects in which I will be comparing to other naval games. And to start with, I think this is very, very good quality. And I would say it's probably, in my opinion, the best naval game on mobile currently. Firstly, with the good graphics, if your device is capable of running this game on max graphics, there is no other naval game with comparable graphics to War Thunder Mobile. It's just absolutely beautiful graphics. I mean, the reflection is amazing, the details on the land and the ships is amazing, and what I'm very impressed by is the fact that the shells reflect off of the water when you fire them. I haven't actually at least noticed that in any other naval battle games that I have tried in the past. And also, gameplay-wise, I find this actually quite entertaining gameplay-wise. I've never been a fan of navy battles, but I have been enjoying these slightly because there's some variation and fun. The only real complaint I have against this is the submarines, which are very, very OP and difficult to take out with your ships. I mean, they're not invincible, but you will be having a very, very hard time to take them out because there are no easy ways to counter them. There's no depth charges. The only way you can really counter them is by shooting them with the cannons when they surface, and that's even difficult because they're a very small target. But when they also surface, you can maybe fire torpedoes at them, but also it's difficult to aim your torpedoes accurately, especially long range. It would be very, very nice if they added something like depth charges to combat submarines when they are in up close to you. So that's the only real complaint I have about the Navy battles. And another thing I like about these two is they're actually very easy to level up, especially compared to ground forces. You level up and get new ships very, very quickly. The economy in the Navy side of War Thunder Mobile is very, very decent. So I'm going to be heading to battle so long in the USS New Orleans, which I've finally been able to get my hands on. And it's probably the first actually reasonable ship you get in the game. The earlier ships are all pretty boring and the same. The cannons are all very much similar to each other. Their speed, everything is similar. This is the first one that actually has a lot of very powerful cannons, but also comes equipped with a plane. Now, the planes are very difficult to use in this game because the anti-air guns on ships are very, very, very good. Currently, the way I find easiest to avoid the anti-aircraft gun is not to necessarily fly high, because that means your bombs are inaccurate. And also, the guns can reach very high altitudes. What I would recommend is actually flying very, very low, as in like 10 meters above the ocean. Because for some reason, the AA guns struggle to fire at very low altitudes like that. So that's what works best for me so far, at least. Although I haven't experimented with the planes too much, because they don't seem to do a lot of damage. They can be useful for scouting enemies, though. Especially when there's none spotted, you can fly over, scout one out, and then at least you know where to look for them. And looks like there's a plane spotted somewhere because there's anti-air fire up there. Alright, we've spotted an enemy right here. And I think I fired a little low there. Okay, no I didn't. Just gonna back up because I'm in a bit of a risky situation right here with two enemy ships in sight. And alright, wow, the guns on this ship are very, very, very strong. They take out enemies very quickly. And okay, the Admiral Hipp has just fired a torpedo at me. I'm gonna have to try and outmaneuver that. What I'm going to do is I'm going to stop and I'm going to just turn my ship away from where the torpedo is being fired. Okay, it's coming towards me, and I think he's gonna miss. Yeah, he's missed me. Which is good for us. And I've got two guys right over here. A Brescenden, which should be very easy to take out, because he's a lower rank ship. And obviously, I have a lot more crew members, so that means I can outlast his fire very easily. Which is saying that he is not capable of doing. Okay, but I am in a bit of a bad situation here. On fire, oh no. Hit some bad spots on the ship. But this guy's nearly finished. And there, another guy destroyed. And now it's just back to this Brescenden here. And I've got a hull breach. Let's try and fix that. Good, that's out of the way for now. And here goes the Brescenden now. It's gonna have to face these super strong guns. As you can see, they're just simply shredding him. He can't do anything against us. We still at 91% health. Even though we've taken many hits, and he's already down to just 6% left. And there, another guy taken out. And now I've just got to deal here with this Eric Geese ship. Alright. Should be pretty quick and easy. Okay, I'm just going to put up smokes for now while I repair the ship. And take cover a little while. And in the meantime, I'll spawn a plane and hopefully I can get a few bombs on him while I'm repairing. Okay, his anti-air fire is starting. But I'm going to fly very nice and low. And as you can see, he's struggling to hit me at this low altitude. Okay, drop the bombs. Okay, missed. And back to the ship. Okay, he's still pursuing us. But I should be able to finish him off with these last rounds left very quickly. And there, another guy finished off, and we've just got... Oh, the Admiral Hipper left. Okay, that is going to be a very difficult target to deal with, because the Admiral Hipper is a rank higher, two levels higher, should I say, not ranks, than the USS New Orleans, and it's a very good ship at that. It's one of the best ships at its rank, never mind against a lower rank ship like me. Okay, trying to fire through the smokes. Hopefully I'll be able to get a shot or two in right through the smokes. At least I've still got a teammate around. Nice, looks like we had one hit. And he's planning on coming back through this side. And hopefully my teammate will be able to help out a little bit. Oh, this is pretty tense. The Admiral Hipper is a very powerful ship. And is a nightmare to deal with. Especially when you're on lower health to him. Okay, here he is, he's back. Let's try and take his cannons out. Let's go for the cannons. Nice, I think I might have damaged his ammunition storage. Okay, let's go full speed at him. Oh no, and I'm hitting the side here, which is slowing me down, making things very difficult. And he's damaged my auxiliary cannons. Okay, I think this is going to be my end right here. Okay, oh, still alive. Just... Nice, set him on fire, nice. We can do this. Oh, wow, what a win. That was absolutely incredible. I cannot believe I actually succeeded in taking down that Admiral Hipper. That was one hell of a big target. And I really thought he was gonna take the victory right there. I mean, that was one very, very fine battle, and I'm very happy with the way it actually went for us right there. So I'm just gonna upgrade my ship so long. With all the extra levels we got on our ship, and I hope you guys enjoyed that video though. Let me know what you guys think of naval battles, and which is your favorite Navy game on Android? Do you think War Thunder Mobile is the best, or maybe it's one of its competitors like World of Warships Blitz or Modern Warships? Let me know in the comments, and if you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe. Thanks guys, see you next time.